What happens when you come home from 8 years and 6 months in prison and nobody there to help? When you can't get no job? When you can't get no support? God, my only hope. What happens when you lose your relationship? When you start sinking and swirling down that drain of depression, like, where ain't nobody there to help you? When you trying to pray, you can't even pray. When you trying to go to church and you feel like you don't even fit in, you can't even get a breakthrough. When you gotta go and get on your knees and you begging God, like, God, send knocking at the door, asking me to open the door, like. And you got nobody, just people just pointing their fingers, like. They just see your past, they just see your flaws, like. They don't understand what's going on inside you, like. They don't understand that passion, like. But they didn't even understand my struggle. They didn't even understand. They didn't even understand why I was out of my life. I'm crying out for help. God bless you, man. This is your brother Sean Turner from Roy Clark Representative, man. I love y'all. You know, I love God with all my heart. I'm a worshiper. I'm 26 years old. I grew up in the streets of Newark, New Jersey. And that's a high crime environment, you know, and one of the strongest things that's a stronghold on my city is addictions, you know? And I'm a living witness today that the change that was on my life is about to be broken. The change that's on your life is gonna be broken today. I smoke weed. I smoke K2. Synthetic marijuana. It's people that's dying, that's falling into comas and not coming out. The spirit of murder, the spirit of death is running rampant in my city. And I'm blowing a whistle on you this day. Adam had authority over the plant. The plant didn't have authority over Adam. And that's what God did when he revealed to me. God gave me this revelation. This revelation really set me free. Adam had authority over the plant. The plant didn't have authority over him. God started to teach me about addiction. A lot of times people fall into addiction when it's a void there. Everybody have a God-shaped hole in their heart. The hole eats whatever they put in that heart. That's why Jesus said, the bread of life. He said, if you drink this water, you will never thirst again. You could do drugs and turn up and drink liquor, smoke the valley, and all these different things. But then you're gonna go right back. We're gonna go right back and do the same thing. Because why? It's not fulfilling. The worst thing that happened to me was when I overdosed. When I overdosed on synthetic marijuana. And people recorded me. Tried to destroy my identity. And God, he tried to use it as a weapon formed against me. That was the worst thing that happened to me. Where I had to get took into the hospital, like. Because I'm not responding. Laying in a hospital bed. My uncle come and play Hezekiah walking in my ears. The nurse comes and tell him, stop playing that in his ears. He's not conscious right now. My uncle says, no. This is what he does. He loves Hezekiah Walker. As he played the Hezekiah Walker in my ear, I started to smile in my hospital bed. And I started to rise up and rip the plugs off of me. Went back out of consciousness. Woke back up. My family was around me. Went back out. Woke back up. Ripped the plugs off me again. I bind you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. Went back out. That's how I knew the God on the inside of me was real. Because I was unconscious and my spirit was breaking up out of that thing. That wasn't my destiny. And no matter what the enemy try to use against me, God is not going to let the enemy prevail, because God is going to move on North New Jersey. God is going to move on Camden, New Jersey. We bind the spirit of addiction this day. We come against it. We stand up and we fight this day. We fight this day. We repent of our sins this day. We renounce drugs and we renounce pride this day. We stand for the kingdom of God. We stand for the kingdom of God. Devil, you can't have us. living proof I am here. Innovative pioneer, let the word pierce they heart, harder than the iron spear. I was born harder than Iron Man's body gear. Buying demons up like Barry, we knock them out of here. That's a child that God's sitting higher for my potty chair. That's the throne, better know Jesus in the atmosphere, moving in dominion. Souls we be winning, stay ahead of the game like Michael Phelps, we be swimming. And Jesus is living, yup, yup, he is living through me. So when I spit, it's like you just hit a limit with Christ. I'm a joint heir, vision like I can't hear. Only moving love and authority, so I can't fear. I be in the field preaching Christ, cause the time is near. I'm climbing higher and higher like a koala bear. I'm in Christ, climbing heights higher than the Eiffel. Stand up like a militaristic soldier, spinning rifles. Listen, it is your right to move in authority. Live your life with Christ like the early church disciple. Heathens, they marveling. Seeds, they be harvesting. Flow like a pit after 9 days of starving it. Angels over me like the aircraft of the inaugural. Only through faith in Christ Jesus can the Father pardon you. He ain't trying to stop you, family. Only trying to bother you. That's why he took more stripes in his back than the Steve Harvey suit. You either get Christ now or die frying. These are the last days, I promise I'm not lying. It's not worth in the moment of glorifying these pleasures and chasing earthly treasures. Thinking death is the end, but it's only a measure. Christ.
Claw.
A whole new way, man. This the claw, man. We the future, man.
Free.
The church, man.
Freedom in Jesus, man.
Ah!